Very much. One of the great things we do each year is be able to tell the stories, to introduce you to the people who benefit from the services at the rehab center. And each year we have a spokesperson, someone who represents us in the community, talks about their story, lets us tell their story, and their families always become very involved in that. I had the great privilege of doing a story on Bethany and Lewallen this year. And so I want you to take a look at our spokesperson this year and find out just why the services that take place at the rehab center are truly changing lives. Take a look at this. In many ways, 14-year-old Bethany Lewallen is a typical teenager. A student at Bonham Junior High School, she's in the band, she was elected treasurer of the student body, and she was the princess at the 8th grade Valentine's dance. But her real passion is apparent when she takes the stage, here in a production of Snow White at the Globe Theater, and just last year in Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream. But look a little closer and you'll see a beautiful young lady struggling with a devastating illness.
She's been diagnosed with what's known called MELAS, which is an acronym for mitochondrial encephalomyopathy with lactic acidosis and stroke-like episodes.
It's a long and complicated name for a disease that is slowly taking away her ability to walk, speak, even swallow.
Started when she was in first or second grade with just having headaches, and we thought, you know, went got her eyes checked, did all the usual parental things.
But the headaches continued to get worse, and after a few years, an MRI revealed what looked like a tumor at the base of her skull. Bethany was airlifted to Cook Children's Hospital in Fort Worth, where a neurosurgeon ruled out a growth, but began talking about the equally devastating diagnosis. Then, last October, a major setback, a string of continuous seizures.
That did some severe damage. She was having balance issues and some other things after that, some issues with identifying objects by name. And at one point, we put some writing in front of her, and she couldn't even read at all.
That's when the Lewallens ended up here at the Permian Basin Rehabilitation Center, and they began the climb to restore Bethany's independence.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but
each week, Bethany works with therapists in occupational, speech, and physical therapy.
Hold it up, 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 up. Hold it. Oh!
In PT, Pat Fierro helps her increase her overall strength. Bethany uses a therapy ball, fighting every second to sit tall as she marches and stretches her legs. And then, when she begins the difficult task of standing and sitting, his hand is right there to guide her. The trick, finding a balance between hard work and plenty of fun.
She's just awesome. I just love her.
In occupational therapy with Angie Long, Bethany works on the computer, mastering those fine motor skills. The goal here is to help Bethany maintain the basic life skills she needs. And even as she struggles to continue her reach and stretch her range of motion, she does it with a smile.
Attitude and effort never changes. She is absolutely always giving 100%.
Down, but no, I'm not brave.
And in speech therapy, Bethany works with Kathy Holman.
Six things that are made out of glass. I have glass.
These two share a special bond as patient and therapist.
You don't remember? Well, your lips.
And as actors who share a passion for the theater.
There's a sense of just, come on, this is not fair. especially when somebody really has and that love of being on the stage. And having that connection with the audience.
It can be frustrating. And I just want to see the world and no one gets it.
While Bethany continues to work hard, she also continues to lose ground, and the changes are coming on very fast.
Even in August, she was a pretty normal kid. It's just seeing things and not being able to do anything to fix it. As a dad, that's really hard. You want to fix things, and there's so many times you can't.
But here at the Permian Basin Rehabilitation Center, they never give up hope.
When a door closes, we're there to push it open, shove it open, squeeze through the crack or whatever we need to do to keep moving forward and get as much as we can.
They've been invaluable in helping her out with not only the walking issues and you know, being able to do things you just take for granted.
And through it all, Bethany continues to encounter typical teenage milestones.
Okay. She has done some things in here that have surprised me, you know, and so.
Specifically, like running into a wall.
Like running into a wall, you know. I figured, you know, she would be a better driver than that, but she's she's one of those that, you know, if you see her behind a wheel of any motorized vehicle, get out of the way.
Watch out! Everybody, get out of the way!
I respect her very much.
She's an amazing kid. She's been an inspiration for us, and she's been an inspiration for a lot of people.
So what happens for Bethany now?
Try to get her the best help we can, and you pray for a miracle, pray for a cure, anything to help her have the most normal life we can.
I'm good, not everyone else. I just something to
deal with. Okay, foot down.
It's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other.
And we always have a lot of laughter through tears when we're here at the Care-a-Thon. This family has become so special to every person they meet. Just talks about how special this little girl is, the little sister, the mom and dad are. James, I'll just start with you. I know you guys have just gotten back from Houston. This is hard, as you said, for a dad to not be able to fix this, right?
Absolutely. You just do whatever you can and take it day by day.
And one of the things I think is so important about your story is that your faith, your support from your church and the support from this community has really been overwhelming for you. Is that right?
Absolutely. It's one of the hidden blessings of having to go through something like this to see how amazing not only our friends and church family, but an entire community of people has been just amazing.
We're as you said, we're very lucky to be West Texans,
and
this story really proves that. Kathy, what happened? What are you and Bethany working on? Because I know it's frustrating for her to not be able to speak as clearly as she once did. So what do you work on?
Well, we continue to work on some language things and just articulation and trying to get everything that we can. Sometimes our therapy sessions end in a laughter war. She gets started and then we can't stop. So we have a good time together.
These two are friends before they started as patient and therapist and after. Kathy, I'm going to let you put the microphone in Bethany's face. And Bethany, I want you to look at that camera and I just want you to say thank you or whatever you want to say to the people, particularly your school buddies at Bonham who have been really supporting you this week. What do you want to say to them? They've really been
amazing.
And I think that really says it all. They're amazing because you're amazing. And we know how hard it is to share this story, how your heart hurts right now. And we just want to say thank you, because this really is why we spend these hours doing this and why your donations make such a big difference to people just like the Lewallens. We'll be seeing them much more throughout our Care-a-Thon, and we're glad you're all here. And she's trying to take my job. So I am tossing it to Jay before she...